Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. You are here because you have purchased or plan to purchase one of our PN series pressure sensors. In this video, we are going to go over the programming of these sensors. So let's get started. So here you have the Learn More section on our website for our PN series pressure sensors. In this video, we are going over the programming of these sensors. In this section, we discuss some commonly used terms in the menu structure, such as HNO, HNC, FNO, and FNC, which are used for the switching outputs, and we also define ASP and AEP, which are used for the analog output. Next, we have a diagram that shows you the display of the sensor, and it defines what the different LEDs indicate. Finally, we go over a list of steps that are used to change different parameters in the sensor. So now, let me take you to the sensor itself and show you how to manually program it using the display and push buttons. In this video, I am using a PN2694. This specific part number has a 1/4-inch MPT male process connection and a measuring range up to 145 PSI. As always, we have other options available with different process connections and measuring ranges. Out of the box, you can see from the display that this sensor is factory set to display in PSI. I am going to show you how to manually program it using the display and push buttons to change the units. So to begin, you would press this enter button to go into the menu. The first thing you see is SP1, which is your set point for output 1. If you hit down, you'll see RP1, which is your reset point for output 1. If you hit down again, you'll see ASP2, which is your analog start point for output 2, and AEP2 for your analog end point for output 2. If you press down again, you'll see EF, which stands for extended functions. And if you press enter, it'll take you into that menu. Here you see RES, which is how you factory reset the sensor. And if you hit down, you'll see OU1, which is where you can set what type of output you use for output 1. As well as OU2, where you can configure what type of output you have for output 2. If you press down again, you'll see DS1, DR1, and then finally you'll see UNI for units. If you press enter once you get to the parameter you want to set, you'll see it is factory set for PSI. Now if you want to change it, you'll hold down either the up or down arrow key until it begins to flash, and then it will scroll through your options. For this video, I'm going to change it from PSI to bar. So once you are on the parameter you want to set, you press enter. And now if I go back to my main display, you will see the LED has changed from PSI to bar. Now if I go back into the menu by pressing the enter button, and you'll see SP1, RP1, and now ASP2, which is your analog start point for output 2. If you press enter, it is factory set for 0, which means at 0 bar, you will get a 4 milliamp output. If you press enter, you'll go back to ASP2, and if you hit down, you'll see AEP2, and if you press enter, it is factory set for 10 bar, which means you would get a 20 milliamp output at 10 bar. If you want to change this, again, you would press down either the up or down arrow keys until it begins to flash and then scroll, and you can set what you want your 20 milliamps to represent. So for example, I can change this to 9.5 bar and press enter. And now my 4 to 20 milliamp output is scaled linearly between 0 and 9.5 bar. So that concludes this Tech Insights video on the programming of our PN series pressure sensors. As always, you can check out our Learn More section on our website for helpful information on any of our products. Feel free to contact us at 1-800-441-8246 to speak with somebody who can assist you. Thank you for your time and have a great day.